is our technology. The problem is you. You lack the will to change. Then help us change. I cannot change your nature. You treat the world as you treat each other. But every civilization reaches a crisis point eventually. Most of them don't make it.
Yours did?
How? Our sun was dying. We had to evolve in order to survive.
So it was only when your world was threatened with destruction that you became what you are now?
Yes.
Well, that's where we are. You say you were on the brink of destruction, and you're right. But it's only on the brink that people find the will to change. Only at the precipice do we evolve. This is our moment.
So here we have a caterpillar that is metamorphing into a butterfly, and this is showing the different stages that it goes through. So we can think of the caterpillar as our civilization and what we are currently going through as the chaos, the precipice. When you see in the center here where the pupa is, there literally is a transformation happening of old cells dying and new cells being formed. And so when you open the pupa, it would just appear to be a bunch of cells. It would appear to be chaos. But what appears to be chaos on the surface is actually the old dying out and the new coming in. So this is part of the transformation process. We see in history several civilizations, falling and dying out. And so perhaps this is the dawn of a new era. And perhaps this is the dawn of a new age, of the age of enlightenment, of the age of transformation, of the age of coming together, of no more separation, of literally coming into who we are, because we are not determined by our genetics. We always think of the idea of our genes determine our destiny, but there is something called epigenetics, above genetics. Our genetics alter and change according to our environment. So we are adaptable and we are evolving according to the environment around us. So remember that this is a process of beautiful transformation. So if you want to look, you may see a greater truth than you've ever been told. And, you know, when we see, that's when we rise. And the Bible even says, you know, knock and the door will be open. Ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. So what you are looking for will find you. What's meant to be will always be. And it's not really about forcing anything. It's about really just allowing things to come naturally. From my experience, I find that the things that we tend to hold on to, be it a belief system or things of the past that we feel obliged to or obligated to based on tradition or generations, those things, it's like holding a rope and you're dangling and your hands are turning red because you're scared to let go in fear of not knowing what's beneath you. And, it's like you're fighting in denial. So it's time to just face yourself and what feels right, regardless of what you've always known, is going to transform your mind from the limitations, essentially expanding your consciousness, essentially rising above the genetics, changing and altering your DNA from within through the light of knowledge. You know, photons are light and the sun emits light. We are light beings. And the more knowledge we have, the more wisdom we gain. And the more wisdom we gain, the more we are able to shine that light and be the lighthouse for others who are finding their way along the path of this new earth.